Hello and welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now actually entering the Grand Colonial Hotel itself. Versus the Brain Eaters. The last role of Halcyon Helen.
The murder has inflicted some...
So much opulence, while most of Halcyon suffers.
Shh. Someone was saying about the murder. I thought it was him talking.
Mr. Kincannon really knows how to run a hotel.
Concierge Halston.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but while the hotel is an active crime scene, I regret to inform you that all new bookings, room upgrades, room downgrades, and in-room massages are suspect. Oh, you're the special inspector. Mr. Kincannon warned me you'd be checking in soon.
Who?
Why, you.
No, not the special inspector. I meant your boss.
Oh, Mr. Kincannon. He runs all sublet underground operations in the Eridanos Atmospheric Complex, including the Grand Colonial Hotel. But he keeps his office down in the warehouse district, near the docks. If you should require to meet with him in person, you're most likely to find him there. While you're here, Inspector, could I set you up with a room?
It's the theme song. You hear that? It's the Outer Worlds theme song. In boom boom, kind of whatever instrument that is. Oh, sure, what do you got?
For you? Only the best, ma'am, of course. You'll be staying in our luxurious penthouse suite, vacated just recently. So recently that unfortunately the room's still being cleaned.
Because the person died.
I'm sure it'll be ready for you by the time you've examined the crime scene. I believe Constable Keane should be waiting for you in the grand ballroom.
We're staying in Halcyon Helen's apartment, aren't we? Or room, whatever. I didn't see the grand ballroom on my way in.
Oh, the ballroom's right behind the tower elevators. Swing a left or a right, then cut through the crowd of spectators. You can't miss it.
Oh. Okay. Oh, I want to read your terminal. How do I get back there? Oh, yeah, I see grand ballroom. I'm gonna have to use this. Check-in terminal. Greetings, Concierge Halston. Acquire a penthouse key? Didn't she just set that up for us? Error. Room not yet ready. Okay. Then how am I gonna stay there? Oh, the Dissident Queen, Chapter 2. Halcyon Helen encounters the Slugmen. Having fought their way past the numerous bandit ambushes and hostile auto-mechanicals, Halcyon Helen and Olympus Opal had found themselves at the gates of the Dissident hideout. "You're a fine partner, easily better than my last," said Helen, "but I dare say these fiends outrank your typical anti-establishment scum. Many of them were scientists before they deserted their corporations, whereupon they stole technology for their own nefarious purposes. I've seen their abominations, and they're more than a typical person can handle. You should return to your job and to the place where you're needed." "Though I know my work was valuable," Opal said, "I am still pleased that I was promoted to assist in your quest to rid the galaxy of those who would threaten the colony's productivity. The two of us together will, I believe, be twice as effective in eliminating the enemies of the board." Helen did not respond, but instead bid her companion be silent, for she had seen that the gates to the Dissident hideout were no longer shut. Someone or something had opened them. That's an interesting hat. Severed head of Burbage 2000? The head of Burbage 2000 torn from its body in the penultimate act of Titus Androidicus. "Why, foolish Burbage, dost thou not perceive that Halcyon is but a wilderness of dissidents, and it is only through our citizens' vigilance that they will be caught, report any and all suspicious behavior to your local constable." I guess that's a prop from...
Keep him quiet, Cap.
Oh, I know. The bypass shunts are used for hacking. I remember now. Pleasure's all mine.
I'll bet you 10 bits this is all just some sort of publicity stunt.
I'm pretty sure she's already dead.
You know, I never imagined Spencer Wolf.
You know, I was nearly attacked by a terror ray on my way here.
At least you say it differently.
Oh, come on. Why is the lounge closed? I wanted brunch.
Bertie Holcomb is likely beside himself in grief.
You're right, it's locked. Okay. Very nice, very nice.
We should try to solve the puzzle hedges in the orchards. The prize is supposed to be something valuable.
Puzzle hedges? This goes out to different areas.
Welcome to the Grand Cologne. If you have an issue with a hotel employee, management has requested that you speak to a security officer, rather than shoot them yourself.
Typically, yes, that's what I do, as long as they're not attacking me.
No, I'm sorry. We don't serve any drinks with those tiny umbrellas.
Well, why not? You really should. Hello? Come on in! Just in case there's stealable stuff as well. Well, these are takes. Fast ration pill. Concierge Terminal. Welcome to the Grand Colonial Concierge Terminal. Please do not store any insufficiently encrypted gossip on the Grand Colonial Concierge Terminal. Guest complaints. I'll hack last. Guest complaints. Good luck! From Annoyed. Subject, this infernal racket. Do you like torturing me? Is that what this is? When I first learned I'd be just beneath the floor occupied by Rizzo's Rangers, I was excited, as any tossball-loving Halcyonite should be. What I did not anticipate is the degree to which these hole heads seem to enjoy prancing to and fro, pounding on their floor and my ceiling, every hour of the architect-cursed day. The architect-cursed day. Did they install a tossball fifth court upstairs while I wasn't looking, or is this normal? And worst of all, it sounds like one of them has decided to start imitating a woolly cow. I'll give them that it's a convincing facsimile, but it has no place in a hotel, and each bleat is so loud it shakes the glasses on my face. Maybe it is an actual cow. I mean, I had cows in my hold for a while. I demand a room change yesterday. For each additional hour after midnight today that I am not rehomed, I expect at least one employee to be fired. Yeah, no. That might actually happen, but... From a concerned Byzantine. Subject, mechanical menace. To whatever member of the help it may concern, I've heard a horrible clanking passing my room every night for the past 6 nights. Yesterday I mustered up all my courage and sent a servant to look, and upon her return, she had seen what looked like an armed mechanical wander by my room for the past 6 nights. She said it was something called a Burbage 3001 and that it was a serial star. If this machine is a serial star, I must ask, why are you filming outside our rooms without paying us? We're not consenting to have our temporary property filmed. There is no doubt a contract for this, and if the machine is being allowed to wander without being filmed, then I want to be paid double. Do you have any idea how dangerous that thing could be? It could have tread on my foot and ruined my aspirations to be a professional dancer, if I ever decide to have those aspirations. I urgently await a response. VIP guest lists. Ruth Bellamy, a.k.a. Halcyon Helen, Spencer Woolrich, and Black Hole Birdie Holcomb. Okay, let's request to manifest for Halcyon Helen. Despite her celebrity status, the greater part of Halcyon Helen's requests have been fairly normal. Soap, shampoo, new towels, and so on. The one exception is her unusual consumption of food and drink. I'm not one to judge about that sort of thing. Law knows I've seen stranger proclivities from other guests, but she really does request a lot, and frequently. Listen to this. For lunch today, she ordered 6 borscht and bean sandwiches, 2 purple berry shakes, 2 purple berry liqueurs, several retro rockets, and cigarettes enough to crush a teacup canid. I'd wonder if she's planning a party, but the cleaning staff say that every time they've gone up, there's been no sign of what she ordered. If Helen really does keep managing to get through all of what she's been ordering, then maybe she should consider quitting show business and entering the competitive consumption scene instead. Okay, and a manifest on Spencer Woolrich. In the past 2 weeks, I have received 315 different service requests from Mr. Woolrich. These requests include, but are not limited to, his entire wardrobe from Terror on Monarch, 413 different outfits, including a primal suit, 5 gallons of each color of spectrum except black, wants 50 gallons of black, teacup canids of various breeds, a plasma launcher, and, consisting of over 60% of all total requests, an upgraded room. Administrator Ludovico authorized him to get into the second largest room just to shut him the hell up, but Halcyon Helen got the biggest one, and of course Woolrich can't accept that he's been eclipsed. Got another room upgrade request as I was typing this. I've more than half a mind to send an exterminator to fumigate his room just so he can't request anything else for a while, but then he might come down here and try to talk to me, and I think I'd quite honestly rather be dead. Alright, Black Hole Birdie Holcomb. Manifest. Holcomb's requests have been about what you expect from a professional skullcracker. Toss balls, toss ball sticks, new clothes because he keeps, and I quote, accidentally tearing the shirts that are too small for my giant muscles. Funny how the rips I've seen look more like they've been made by hand. I've noticed that he's asked for very little in the way of effort accelerators or enhancers. No skin tough, no oxycomp, not even any dervish mist. Typically, toss ball players go through that filth like no one else. Maybe Holcomb's trying to prove something to Helen. Whatever it is, I don't think it's going to work. Alright, I think I should go sneak to hack. Access restricted messages. To concierge from Cedric Kincannon. Subject, that damn fool. Halston. I reason to believe Ludovico is getting agitated again, which will likely present itself in several dozen messages to you, each demanding a reduction in Rizzo's payments. Funnel these messages into the trash, if you please. If Ludovico wants to renegotiate the terms of our contract, he's welcome to take his operations elsewhere. Cedric. Yeah, these two really don't get along. Tab? Yeah. Sealed.
Hello there, my inordinately esteemed guest. If my hello were any more earnest, this loudspeaker would explode.
I don't want to explode.
Oh dear, I'm sorry, but you don't seem to have a registered room key. If you've lost your key, why don't you pay the hotel concierge a visit? I'm sure she can get you a new one. Then you can come back, and I'll service all of your vertical needs.
My vertical needs? Bishop Bellhop Norville.
The crime scene's awaiting, Inspector. Can't believe something like this could happen in my hotel. When I found her, I was just hoping she had a little too much to drink, but all the grievous bodily injury adds up, I suppose.
She was lying in a pool of blood, and your first thought was, I wonder if she's drunk?
Hey. Byzantines and restraint aren't two words that often go together. Wouldn't be the first blood-soaked, unconscious party-goer I've come across. Anyway, I'm sure you've got questions.
Did you see Helen on the day of her death?
Of course I did. I just told you I found the body.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. You mean when she was still breathing?
Right.
No, of course I didn't. Plus, it's untoward for an employee to speculate about the actions of a hotel guest. Not that I saw any hotel guests interacting with her.
I think we both know that you're itching to gossip.
Honestly, you're more than a little right. I've been burning at the britches to share my theories.
I'm sure you have.
The day of her death, I saw Helen leave the hotel premises of the Prophet of Profitability, and didn't see her come back. A little on the suspicious side, I think. Seemed especially strange, seeing how, as far as I was aware, the two didn't get on.
What's the deal with the Prophet of Profitability? Is she a guest?
Yep. Gives seminars on increasing profit margins and the like. Can't say much else, seeing how I ain't in the gossip market.
You like the gossip, I know. Why didn't Helen and the Prophet get along?
As far as I can recall, Helen dismissed the lady's seminars in some kind of interview. Said her co-star used them, but she didn't. The top rungers are always ready to read between the lines of famous folks and seem to think the Prophet was on her way out. Woman lost a ton of bits and is set to lose more.
Well, back to my other questions.
I hope all that helped. I'd like to be as useful as I can in the investigation. I just didn't want to steer anyone the wrong way.
That's fine. You want to give me more details on how you came across the body?
Sure. I'd taken to checking the barroom every few hours prior to the unveiling. Just to make sure no sprats had snuck into the place. You understand? Found her right before I was set to head back to my room in the lower levels for my mandated 5-hour sleep period. Tell ya, thank the law for caffeinoid. Been too upset to get a wink of sleep since. And hey, now I can finally see smells.
Any idea why Helen would have been in the ballroom after hours?
Beats all hell out of me. Maybe she was, practicing for the unveiling?
Okay, I just have to. Did you kill Helen? You can tell me if you did. It'll be our secret.
What? No! Just because I found the corpse doesn't mean I made her a corpse.
Sure.
I was in shift all day. Besides, I loved Helen serials. Well, the old ones anyway. The newer episodes are hot junk on a warm day.
Oh, really?
Sure. What's on your mind?
You got any idea who might have wanted to do Helen in?
Everyone's got theories. I don't reckon mine hold much more weight than anyone else's.
Alright, in that case, bye.
With Halcyon Helen gone, does that mean Spencer Woolrich will get all her roles?
I certainly hope not. That man doesn't even act as well as I do. Mr. Kincannon really knows how to run a hotel.
You know? I never imagined Spencer Woolrich would outlive Halcyon Helen.
I did not read about this kind of treatment in the service agreement papers.
Still waiting to get in there, huh? That goes out to the outside pool. Thought they might have also an in-ground pool. Vending machines. That's the one I just talked to. That's the ballroom there. Alright, let me run up the stairs and see what's on that second floor. Join us for the Prophet of Profitability Seminar. A flyer promoting a productotherapy seminar with renowned Prophet of Profitability Jasmine Leva at her retreat in the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. Under her patented system, purge your body of nefarious humors, stopping you from unlocking your true productive potential. You don't say. Constable Keane is over there. Nothing in here. Hi. Talking a lot, but you're not saying anything.
I can't believe Helen's gone.
I can't believe Helen's gone. We're never gonna get a sequel to Terror on Monarch.
People all think alike, I guess. I'm sure stocking up on my purple berry liqueur. Hi.
Mr. Kincannon really knows how to run a hotel.
I can't believe Helen's gone. I can't believe Helen's gone. We're never going to get a sequel to Terror on Monarch.
Rum and something.
Murder or no murder, it is my right to loiter on a bar stool. How else should I be expected to avoid my wife?
Huh. Medical center. Well, that's sealed as well.
Shh. What the? I was going to wash my hands, I swear.
Hi.
I was nearly attacked by a terror ray on my way here.
We picked our way into the bathroom.
Hello? Hello? Can't you let me in yet? I've been waiting almost 15 minutes.
The correct wait time is 15 hours. But I can see how you'd be confused. Oh, I didn't talk to him.
Why'd Helen have to go and die in our hotel? We don't need that kind of notoriety.
You're probably notorious enough on all on your own. Oops. Alright, the ballroom awaits. Needler. TNL Needler. Suit your every need. Fillable with a wide variety of fast-acting combat chemicals. Those are my favorite kind of chemicals. Combat chemicals. So with this we need employee access card level A.
Black Hole Bertie's disappeared, you know. That poor fellow must be inconsolable.
You know, I never imagined Spencer...
Bertie Holcomb is likely
beside himself in grief.
Bertie Holcomb is likely beside...
You know, I never imagined...
Sublight Underground appreciates your patronage.
Well, at least you say something different.
I knew I should have gotten her autograph when I had the chance.
It seems death is just another form of entertainment around here.
Huh. Investigation in progress. Please enjoy the hotel's amenities. You waving at me? Hi.
Rizzo's cares about the happiness of its family. Spacer's choice can't say that.
Am I allowed to pass the cordon?
Company gives us a discount on Spectrum Brown.
Dr. Goodnight? Well, I'm authorized to go in here. Thank you for not attacking me.
Oh,
that's her?
Thank the law.
Hello,
Inspector,
Constable.
You don't know how relieved I am to see you.
Constable Keane, nice to meet you. We spoke over the ether wave.
Constable Maria Keane. It's good to meet you in person, Inspector.
Dr. Goodnight. Ecstatic to make your various acquaintances and so on. Are we finished with the pleasantries? There's something I'm excited to show you.
I'm guessing you're talking about the body?
What body? Oh, that.
What?
Goodness, no. This is far more interesting than Halcyon Helen's rapidly cooling corpse.
Our coroner has developed a device which may prove useful in your investigation. Our office has instructed her to hand it over to you.
Oh.
Our office has instructed her to hand it over to you.
Oh, please. You make it sound as if I'm turning over stolen goods. Behold, my discrepancy amplifier.
Clues
in Hold it in your hands. Feel the way it hums with ontological potential.
Equip the discrepancy amplifier to search for them. As in clues. Discrepancy amplifier. Okay. Interesting. I'm guessing this device makes use of deterministic calculus?
You're rather sharp in your upper story. I can see why you're the inspector. The discrepancy amplifier uses a deterministic model of our universe to detect the discrepancy between what should be and what actually is. Then it renders any discrepancies visible by using the power of magnification.
That sounds strangely like scientism. Expecting the doctrine of the OSI to have any bearing on reality is quite an assumption.
Oh, goodness, no. I don't care for OSI doctrine. I just enjoy their math.
So it's a magnifying glass.
Yes. It's a magnifying glass, but an extraordinarily powerful one. It looks through the glass of reality itself.
I'm what? Contractually prohibited from endorsing off-brand technology, but I'll bend that rule just this once. You'll want to peer into the amplifier and examine the crime scene.
Whoa. Okay. I forgot how loud the level up was. And awesome. Greetings, Inspector. Thanks to the half-genius, half-mad scientific mind of Dr. Goodnight, you've been granted the discrepancy amplifier, a handy investigation device for uncovering clues throughout Eridanos. Be sure to equip the discrepancy amplifier in a weapon slot before you continue your hunt for Helen's killer. Alright, before I even do that, let me just... Oh.
Searching for clues, are we, Captain?
Yes?
Take a look at the crime scene. I'll stay out of your way until you're done.
I like being stayed out of way.
Go on, Inspector. Give the amplifier a try.
How does this thing work again?
The discrepancy amplifier is designed to be held in your hand and maneuvered about, not unlike a small arms weapon. Peer through the looking glass and aim the amplifier about. Examine the crime scene. Find a discrepancy and make a deduction. Simplicity itself.
Okay, actually I wanted a word as well.
Ah, I was waiting for this. Yes, of course. I'm only too eager to cooperate.
Tell me about the body. What's the cause of death?
Our leading lady must have riled up someone. Her wounds from cranium to metatarsal are as follows. A blow to the head, severe enough to lacerate the flesh. Followed by a suite of plasma burns down the neck and back, signs of poisoning, evidence of inanition and desiccation, possible signs of jaundice, some shingles, one malformed toenail.
A malformed toenail? Okay, let's stick to the most likely cause of death.
That's good advice. I'll just strike out malformed toenail as a possible cause of death. The short version is this. Helen was killed by poison, a blow to the head, and a plasma weapon. Possibly more.
Gee. Someone really trying to be thorough. I'll bear that in mind. There was one other thing.
I am, of course, at your service.
I'd like to know a little more about you.
Oh, why, I'm flattered, Inspector. Let me think. I've worked at the Grand Colonial for about as long as it's been around. Prior to that, I lived in Byzantium, but I always felt like it was missing something. And that something turned out to be corpses. Byzantium has much in the way of luxury, but examining the dead does not rank amongst the preferred activities of the elite.
Sounds like you enjoy being a coroner.
Absolutely. Usually I'm just a medical practitioner, so I almost never get to deal with anything as unique or as quiet as a corpse. The most interesting thing I saw prior to this was the back of Mr. Woolrich's throat after he blew out his vocal cords shouting at an attendant. If I weren't here, I'd be back in my quarters, rewatching Byzantium in the spring, or working on my automatic sprat peeler.
Alright.
Always a pleasure, Inspector.
Alright, well, before we equip this thing, we'll look around without it. That's locked. We need to unlock all the things. I need access to everything for my investigation. Thank you very much. It's still so funny how it's playing the Outer Worlds theme. Is this thing on? Plenty of the new Spectrum Brown. Where's this go? Oh, that goes out. Well, they've cleared all the stuff out of here.
Beep, beep, beep. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Huh. Alright, well. We also got perks. Wow, I don't remember this stuff. Can I. How do I take away? I don't know. No, that's fine. Okay, apply. Perks. Oh, wow. I remember this. Reduce the detection radius of enemies when you have no companions. That's not helpful to me. Okay, thick skin. All area of effect and plasma damage dealt to you is reduced by 15%. Cool. Equip the discrepancy amplifier and search the crime scene by aiming. Even if you don't find anything useful, you at least give the impression that you know what you're doing. A replacement for the discrepancy amplifier can be found in the medical center located upstairs from the Grand Colonial lobby. A replacement. Is the one where is the one we have going to break or something? You've learned that Helen disparaged the Prophet of Profitability's work seminar as harming her image and costing her bits. Investigate whether or not this would have motivated the Prophet to kill Helen. You'll need to find and interrogate the Prophet of Profitability regarding her involvement with Halcyon Helen's murder. The Prophet runs her seminar retreats out of an extreme productivity camp deep in the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. Wilderness Exploitation Reserve? Alright, so where is this thing? That's a shrink ray. There it is. Oh, it's got a magazine. Most handgun skill. Designed by Dr. Goodnight, the discrepancy amplifier is an inductive reasoning simulator and computation device fine-tuned to pick up discrepancies in the Eridanos atmospheric complex. The device requires the strong magnetic fields of the Eridanos complex and cannot function anywhere else in the colony, of course. This is it? All right. This is it. To catch Helen's killer, you need to use the discrepancy amplifier scope to reveal clues not visible to the naked eye. Once you've located some evidence, aim directly at it while zooming in with the scope and press the interact button to analyze it. Analyze.
The discrepancy amplifier is now operational. Greetings, designated inspector and or unauthorized larcenist. This unit has detected a discrepancy related to Halcyon Helen. Unscheduled expiration of. Begin amplification?
You can talk?
The discrepancy amplifier has been programmed to function as a helpful and perceptive aid to the enterprising inspector in the absence of a reliable deputy.
Oh, you'll love this. Amplifier, tell the inspector about your features.
Please do not interrupt the discrepancy amplifier. The discrepancy amplifier is programmed to take instruction from its registered or designated inspector.
How curious. I must have set its impertinence levels to flagrant.
This unit's features include an automated personality simulator. This unit has been programmed to simulate joy and satisfaction in assisting you.
Okay. So it looks like she scrawled B, probably in her own blood. Unless it's... Yeah, it's probably blood, unless it's stuff spilled out of this stuff. But I'm guessing that the B has been erased, so that's where the discrepancy is. So, okay, let's get started. Tell me about this discrepancy you found.
This is a bottle of unreleased Rizzo's product.
Brown?
Talon appears to have attempted to use it to spell something as she expired, but all she managed was a sticky B.
Okay, so it's not her blood. I doubt she was spelling out Brown. What's the unreleased Rizzo's product?
Rizzo's Spectrum Brown has not yet been released for consumption. Spectrum Brown was scheduled to be unveiled at the Eridanos Atmosphere Complex in partnership with Halcyon Helen.
Was she trying to spell the name of her killer?
This hypothesis is plausible, but requires additional information.
Isn't Black Hole Birdie staying here? That's two bees.
Mr. Birdie Holcomb is indeed known to frequent places of leisure and hospitality, as rare as they are in Halcyon.
Correct. Bertie Blackhole Holcomb is a registered guest at the Grand Colonial Hotel.
Anybody else I should know about?
Accessing guest database B. The Grand Colonial Hotel is proud to serve the following VIPs. Bertie, comma, Blackhole. Burbage 3001.
Burbage again. Okay, make a note of this for later, Amplifier.
This evidence has been recorded for later reference. Now generating pre-approved compliment. Splendid work, Inspector.
Don't patronize me. Footsteps. Wait a minute. Here we go. Ah! Wrong.
This footprint stands out from the normally spotless floor of the Grand Ballroom. Typically, the ballroom is cleaned twice daily, which means this must have been made by either Helen or her assailant or assailants.